Good morning, dear students. We have already discussed about the simple permanent tissues, the parenchyma, the colenchyma, the sclerenchyma. We have also discussed how to distinguish them. That's a very important question. So you might be asked to distinguish them. So for that, you have to write them pointwise and also draw diagrams to explain the same. Today we will discuss another type of permanent tissue, which is also a type of parenchymatous tissue at times. This is the protective tissues. This includes your epidermis and the cork cells. I hope you know what is cork cells. You remember the scientist who first observed the cells under the microscope? He had observed the cork. Cork is the wooden part of the cell. These are all made up of permanent tissues. So let's discuss about epidermis first. Children, this is a transverse section of the leaf. You see, a section has been cut from here, and this is the structure. The outermost layer, the upper, is the upper epidermis, and again the lowermost layer is the lower epidermis. These blue marked portion is your stomata. So epidermis is the outermost single layer cell. This is commonly a single layered, and xerophytic plants, that is plants which live in conditions where there is less water, you will find a thick layer of epidermis. Other than that, everywhere you will find a single layer epidermal cells. They are elongated and closely packed. Intercellular space does not occur between them. They are generally thickened on their outer and radial sides and thin walled on the inner side. That means the outer portion will be thick walled and inner portion will be thin walled. Aerial parts, the outer thick wall has also a water resistant layer, which is made up of cuticle. So cuticle is quite thick in xerophytic plants. Now what are xerophytic plants? I just now told you, the plants which live in arid regions, that is dry regions, they are the xerophytic plants. So epidermal cells are the outermost layer found on different plant parts. They are modified based on their habitat. Depending upon the plant part, the epidermal cells are packed and closely packed without any intercellular space. They don't have any intercellular space. They are tightly packed. The epidermal cells are modified at different parts depending upon the functions they perform. Like on the leaves, you will find stomatas are present, which are again modified epidermal cells. They help in transpiration and also exchange of gases because they are openings. And I had asked you all to draw the diagrams, so you know how stomatas are. They are protected by guard cells. When the guard cells are turgid, the stomata pore is open. When they are not turgid, the stomatal pore is flaccid. The stomata are enclosed by kidney-shaped guard cells. Then in the aerial parts are also present this waxy layer called cuticle. The waxy layer is known as cuticle. This helps in protection and reduction of invasion of pathogens. It also reduces desiccation, that is, it prevents loss of water from the surface of the plant parts. In the roots, these are modified into root hairs. Like over here, this is an enlarged portion of the epidermal cells of the root, where the epidermal cells have become root hairs. Because of the waxy cuticle above the epidermis, water cannot stand or it does not get absorbed on the leaves. You will find the leaves shiny because of the presence of the cuticle. This is a three-dimensional structure of the leaf again. You see the thick cuticle is represented as the sheath. See, this is the transparent, semi-transparent cuticle which has been lifted. This is the cuticle which is waxy. This reduces transpiration or excess loss of water. Have you seen the bark of the tree? What are they? They are the epidermal cells which have now become dead cells and becomes bark of the tree. See how the bark of the tree has been peeled off. Under the microscope, the bark appears a very dark band. You see over here this dark band. This is your bark. So the cork is the outer protective layer of older stems and roots. It is formed by secondary lateral meristem called the cork cambium. We have discussed that there is also a type of parenchymatous cells present which help in dividing, that is the cork cambium, and they produce secondary cortex and they help in increasing the girth of the plant. You remember the lateral meristem, it helps in increasing. There is one more, cork cambium, which helps in increasing the girth of the plant. Now these cork cells are formed when the outermost layer cells, have you seen cracks on the trunk of the tree? This is because the cells have cracked. They have cracked away, they have become dead cells, they become the bark of the tree. This is again a picture of the bark of the tree. The cells of the cork are dead, compactly arranged. They do not have intercellular space. It forms bark of the tree. It's a thick layer. You might have seen. Have you seen dalchini, cinnamon? It is also the bark of the tree, which we use as spices. Now, a chemical substance known as suberin is present in their walls and it makes them impervious to gases and water. So, this layer, the bark, is impervious. This is also a modified epidermal cell. Now, it has become dead cells. It has chemicals which we call them as suberin, and they do not allow entry of water or substances through them into the tree. So, to sum up, the epidermis forms the boundary of the plant and they prevent water loss, they regulate gaseous exchange, at times they secrete metabolic compounds, they absorb water and minerals, especially in case of your roots. The epidermis on the epidermis of most leaves show dorsoventral anatomy, that is, there's a difference in the upper and lower part of the leaves. The woody stems, other than the stem structures, produce a secondary covering called the periderm, which replaces the epidermis and becomes a protective covering, which later on becomes the bark of the tree. So the epidermal cells can be modified as guard cells or trichomes, which are again certain extensions in the epidermis, or they can be specialized cells.